enacted by the people of the city is starting to become a reality. You know, all the detailed work we've been doing as a team about how we're breaking all those policies down into a deliverable action plan over the next 4 years to make sure that what we set to the people of the city will be delivered and will become a reality. And it's great that there's a number of reports that are coming forward today's cabinet meeting which absolutely demonstrates some delivery towards some of those policies already. So when we set to the people of the city that we were going to hit the ground running, I believe we have, and we've made a really good start at what we can do over the next 4 years. Obviously, as well, the past month has seen some challenging things and some really, really good things. And two I will just kind of pull out because I think it's appropriate to reference them. Obviously, it was very challenging last week when we had the Ofsted announcements that had come forward. I'm not going to repeat everything that we said when those came forward, but I do think it's appropriate just to mention about the practical work we've already been doing to start our improvement journey. And Councillor Parsons, alongside the Chief Executive, met with the Department for Education so we can start working through our action plan for delivery. I think that was a good practical and constructive start to that approach so we can fix our children's services. I'm also very pleased that shortly we should be able to make a very positive announcement about a brand new Director of Children's Services for the City Council. Obviously, more news to follow on that, but I'm very positive we've got a good step in the right direction there. Whilst that obviously was a very challenging episode, no doubt the most challenging episode of the past month, we shouldn't let the opportunity go by just to again mention the exceptional and brilliant episode of the past month, which of course was the city hosting Eurovision. I know we all sort of were really, really proud of how everyone within the council, across the partners, the business community, the whole of the city put together to deliver, you know, the very best Eurovision Song Contest in the competition's history. But obviously, we're proud but never satisfied. You know, we're already starting to think about where we're going to go next and what we're going to do to secure that legacy. It's absolutely great that we're going to be hosting the Kiev Pride as part of that. And very shortly, working closely with Steve Gordon and the Commodore Authority and all of our partners across the other five districts of the city region, we should have some positive announcements about how we're going to secure the legacy Eurovision, how we actually continue to deliver our exceptional approach to culture and the visitor economy in this city and across the region, and equally use that as a really good focus for inward investment into the city as well. So some really good and positive stuff that will be coming forward. So a busy month, but that's exactly as it should be. We've pledged to the people of the city hard work, not fireworks. That's what we're going to deliver. And the most professional administration this city's ever seen. I honestly believe after the first month we've made a really good step in that right direction, and we'll continue that over the next 4 years of the term. So if we move into the actual business and start taking some of those decisions that start delivering on our programme. Well, the next item actually is the minutes of the cabinet held on the 21st of April, so can I move that those minutes from that last meeting are agreed accordingly? And let's move into item 3 then, which is cabinet recommendations. And I think item 3A, Councillor Barrington, you're going to bring forward the House Investment Programme, call-off contract update and proposal for financial years 2023-24 and 2024-25. Dan, over to you. Thank you,
sir.
Shout out.